Hello everyone and welcome back to Pine Mountain Sanctuary. Yes, we are back in it again, and today we are building a snow leopard enclosure. Yes, very exciting. It's the very first time I'm building for these animals, so it was quite a challenge. So if you are new here, if you haven't heard about Pine Mountain Sanctuary before, this is a little collaboration project between me, Simply Savannah, SDM Wolf, and Beyond Root TV. And as you might know, there has just been an announcement for the North America Animal Pack, which is perfect for this zoo because we are building in a Northwest Pacific style. Apparently, that's a thing. I'm not from the US, so I have no clue what I'm doing, but apparently people seem to like it, so that's good. We are having a lot of fun, and of course this is probably gonna be the final like non-North America pack animal you will see it for a while, because of course we're gonna add them all to this wonderful project. So right now, what am I doing? So I did a little bit of research on the snow leopard enclosures, and apparently verticality is very important for these animals. So what I did, I lowered the terrain on the front. I made the terrain on the back a little bit higher, so guests have a perfect view on the animals. And then you have like different levels, as you can see, creating them right now. And we'll do a lot of rock work if you do like a little Google search on these kind of enclosures. Like all the new ones will look like this, and the older ones will be like a fence, and that's it. So I tried to make it look a little bit more like modern, the way they would make it in these days, because this is in the like Asia area of the zoo. We have red pandas, we have giant pandas, and that's why I'm adding these animals as well. I think that was a perfect fit. So as you can see, I'm using a lot of rocks as usual, and it's gonna work out really well in the end, I think. So a few things that these animals need. So the verticality, I already talked about that, and then these animals like to live alone, but of course there's probably some kind of breeding program usually around, so you will need an area to separate the animals. So that's what we are also building. We are doing a little backstage area also where they can separate the animals, because they don't like living together, only during like mating season, stuff like that. So on the other side, we're gonna do like a more old-fashioned kind of habitat for these animals, which is gonna be like a separation area. Right now, Louis bring on like making a little water section right over here, trying to get the right water color. I don't experiment with that a lot, so I have to do that more often. So that's what we are doing. As you can see, it's looking very gray, a lot of rocks, but that's the realistic touch that we are doing. I mean, making some shelter areas. Of course, these aren't really usable in the game, but it looks realistic. Like in real life, these animals would, you know, be able to crawl under it and have a bit of a rest over there while the guests still have a good look on them. Then this little back section, even more verticality in there, a lot of rocks. In the end, as I said, the habitat, they can use it, but you will see a flying snow leopard every now and then. There is not much transversible area left, but in my in my experience in real life, this would be usable, and this is what you would see. So that's what I'm going for with this one. Some enrichment items on this part, and then this part is already almost finished. Some simple foliage. I used a lot of stuff that we already created in this park. I want to make sure that the entire park looks nice, and there is like a kind of a theme going on. You will see the same things more often in the zoo. So some of the rock work and some of the education parts. I used a wall that Savanna created in the previous episode for the giant pandas, and using some of the fences I already created in a previous episode. So if you haven't seen them yet, make sure you check them all out. There's a playlist on the channel, which is also linked to all the other creators. So you can check out all the episodes, which is a very good thing to do, of course, before the North America pack is gonna launch, because you will see this project more often once we have the pack that we were hoping for. You will see some stupid Steam pop-ups every now and then. Sorry for that. This was the very first build I did on my new laptop. I want to be able to play the game and make some content while I'm traveling. So I bought a new laptop, which is able to run the game very easily. And I forgot to switch off the Steam pop-up. So you will see it every now and then. I'm sorry for that. I know it's a bit annoying, but it's especially in the beginning of the video. I don't know. Once I started playing, everyone started playing. And then you will have a lot of pop-ups. But this is the separation area that I was talking about. Creating a little new fence over here, which you would see for these kind of animals. These animals can climb, these animals can jump very high. You have to make sure that it's all safe. So these kind of fences, you would see them for animals like this. Then, I also wanted to have like a little gate so it would be able for the keepers to move the animals from one place to the other. Using the same little trick as I did with the red pandas right over here. So this is more like a little hatch for the animals. They can, you know, open it from indoor probably. I don't know. There's not much, like that much detail in there. But in my imagination, they would be able to open it from the indoor part. And then the animals are able to... to go to the other section, because this outdoor section, there's not much there. There is only a few rocks, and I do think like for the animal welfare, it's important to make sure that both animals can use the other side every now and then. But once they are like in their indoor enclosures, they would also be able to go outside and don't get locked up. I think we did a good job with that. It's only two animals. It's quite a big area for them, I think, but I like that. I like building some realistic but also like keeping in mind the animal welfare, which is very important, of course. So the other outdoor section, as I said, a couple of rocks, beautiful rocks. I'm using the tiger rocks. The others were using temperate rocks, so I try to blend them in a little bit. You will see me switching to the temperate ones and putting them in between, and make a little mix out of it. And then in the end of the video, we're gonna do another like real-time overview, and you will see the end result, because I did cut out like placing fences and finishing off the area a little bit. I thought it wasn't very interesting to watch me place foliage again for another 10 minutes, and I think it's better to do like a little real-time overview. If you are enjoying these, please let me know down in the comments, and if you don't, also let me know down in the comments, because then I know if I should do them more often. We did that in the Red Panda video, and I did see that the viewing time was a little bit higher, so that means you guys were enjoying it, so I'm trying to do that more often. Then a little bit of a simple interior. First, I wanted to do no interior, and I was like, I can do some of it. It's very, very simple. Just two different cages connected with like a little hallway cage kind of thing, using the same door as I created for the red panda habitat over here. But this will be like a double door. So I don't know. You will always see this. There must be a reason. If you want to know the reason, you can ask Leader. He will probably know. And once he hears this, he will probably place a comment down in the comment section, so you can read it over there. But yeah, there's like a little airlock over here, probably safety reasons, and like a little connection in between the two cages. A lot of these mesh fences, I think that's the best addition that we already had in the game together with the Africa pack. And I do hope that we get some pieces like this together with the North America animal pack. I really hope we get some general pieces together with the 1.7 update. Hopefully some backstage part. I always complain about this in every single video, so maybe they've listened, who knows. Some little brooms and stuff like that for the backstage areas too. Have a bit more props instead of like 2,000 pieces on a cabinet, something like that. We would love that. At least I would, to make it look a little bit more interesting. So on the inside we have like the plaster walls, and on the outside we have the wooden walls, because I'm trying to stick with the same theme. I'm thinking about the next habitat though to create a bit of a different building, otherwise it's gonna be too repetitive and it's gonna be boring for you guys to watch and for me to build, which isn't good. So I'm thinking to do a little bit more like an old-fashioned habitat next, which is a little bit more worn down. But I will have to see how I'm gonna do that. And maybe while I'm building, I will come up with a completely different idea. That's what always happens. So yeah, you will see it. It will be for one of the new animals. I didn't decide which one yet, but yeah, you will probably see the episode around the launch of the new North America pack. The nice thing about this pack though is for us, you can already start building before you have the pack. You don't have to wait for any early access or whatever, because there aren't really new pieces anyway. So yeah, you can build the habitat, and once the pack is released, you can throw the animals in and you will have a beautiful new habitat with the new animals. Yeah, I'm trying to make the habitat as useful as possible, so I'm using the normal habitat doors over here. The two indoor areas, in the end, they are also usable. They are two different habitats, and then I also separated the animals, so both habitats contain one animal in the end, which is looking really, really nice. So in a few minutes, we are gonna do a real-time overview. Then I'm gonna talk with you guys about what we did, and I'm gonna show you the final result. So for now, please enjoy the rest of the speed build, and I'm gonna speak to you guys in a few minutes. All right, so welcome to the finished habitat. And as you can see, I did a bit of like finishing up over on this side. So just to show you guys quickly where the habitat is located. So over here we have the beautiful entrance, as we showed in a previous episode. Then we have like the little shopping area. And I think there's also a path going this way. We have the beautiful wolf habitat from SDN. Then the Formosan black bear habitat on the left, our first episode. Then over here we basically enter like the Asia or China section with the red pandas. And then on the left you will have this a beautiful snow leopard enclosure. As you can see, I tried to work a little bit more with the terrain, so there's a little height difference. I know that's one of the things I struggle with, to make it look a bit more natural, especially for this area. It's very important to do something like that. So just to show you guys the verticality in this habitat, I think we did quite a lot, as you can see. So there's a huge difference in between the top of the habitat and the bottom, and the animals can go all the way up. As you can see, he's chilling over here right now, and the guests still have a really good view on the animals. You can't really see him at the moment because he's all the way at the back, but everywhere the animal is walking, you can still perfectly see it from basically every angle. So on the other side, this is the separation area, so another little outdoor section that we did. A bit of an old-fashioned style, double fencing. Make sure the kids don't stick their hands through, because they will get bitten off by these animals. I'm not sure where the other snow leopard is. She might be inside. I do hear it. Yeah, there you go. So this is the indoor section. As I said, it's also a usable habitat with the door in it. I did some lighting on the inside as well. A few little props. I don't know why, but I put a snow leopard print on here. It looks a little bit weird, so I might remove it later. It could use a bit more props. I used some blueprints here and there. I used the clipboard that I created in the Red Panda video. But yeah, as usual, I would love to see a few more props. Also on this little backstage area, of course, there's just not much going on right now, but once we get like a few nice pieces, I will definitely put them in. So a little thing I also added, which you didn't see in the video, were these things along these columns, but because I think these animals are able to climb them. So yeah, this is like an anti-climbing thing, I don't know. Looks maybe a little bit too small, might be, but yeah, I thought about it, which is the good thing, right? Yeah. Then on the back, we have these beautiful trees everywhere. We have some education, some fencing. We have to finish this area up a little bit with some foliage and stuff, but I didn't want to do that yet. Otherwise, I would ruin my own cinematics, because as you can see, there's not much sunlight here. I can't really get a good sunlight on the building, for example. So adding more trees would make that even more difficult, but we will do that in the end, of course, because it will be a really nice area. When you enter this area, you can see you have the beautiful giant panda habitat from Savannah on the back, and then a lot of foliage, a lot of green stuff. There's a nice areas between the habitats. It's not too crowded. I think we did a good job with that. But yeah, there's still a lot of space left, as you can see. So the giant pandas, we already have them. There are a lot of bear species left that we need to do. I just wanted to do something else for now. I mean, we also have the snow leopard, or the polar bear. We have him left. I think a couple of like grizzly bear, stuff like that. So there's a few more bear species that we need to do. The beautiful, I am still amazed by this building, by the way, the visitor center. It's amazing. It needs to be finished off on the back end and the interior. I think Drew was gonna do that in one of his videos, but we will see. Right now, Simply Savannah and me are still building in a project. Drew and SDN are taking a little break from it and are really excited to jump back in once we get the pack. They didn't have much inspiration for now, but yeah, I just wanted to do a Snow Leopard enclosure because I haven't done that yet and it would fit perfectly in this area. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys liked the little overview that we did. Make sure you leave a comment down below and let me know what you think about it. If you enjoyed, please hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do. And I'm going to speak to you guys in the next one. Yoo-yoo!